Welcome to 6:30 Central. I'm joined by Craig O'Neill to start a very interesting discussion tonight, a topic that ties into Valentine's Day because it deals with living happily ever after.
Exactly. It's all about money. There's a reason why, Dawn, in most traditional vows, wedding vows, for richer or poor, comes before sickness and health. Mm-hmm. In any relationship, at any stage, money's going to be something that has to be dealt with.
Yeah, statistics would bear that out. It is a top factor in reasons for divorce. And in a state that U.S. News says has the third highest divorce rate nationally, it's time we talked about marriage and money.
Or, as I like to call it, matri-money. Thomas Sharp loves his new hobby, bees. Peaceful, relaxing, you get the honey as a bonus. His parents would be so proud that he was being so frugal. But that was something he rebelled against in his younger days. When he rolled up enormous sums of consumer debt and paying it off, he made a discovery.
Oh, my parents know what they're talking about.
He's now more like his parents. Thomas's wife, Sarah, had been brought up in a comfortable atmosphere.
But once I got out on my own and I got that first credit card, that's when I got in trouble.
Stop. You got it all wrong.
She would bring a huge chunk of debt into her marriage with Thomas.
You don't feel the money when you use a credit card.
She was actually scared that I didn't want to date her anymore because of how much debt she had.
A few blocks away at the home of Thomas's best friend, Reggie, the roles were reversed.
So I was more the natural miser kind of personality.
Before he and Shara met, he too racked up some steep consumer debt.
And this was done all on credit cards.
He thrift versus thrill with money, and you add a first child to the mix, it would appear these relationships have got challenges.
A lot of times you'll have a couple where one of them is a saver and the other is a spender.
Chelsea Wakefield is director of the Couples Center at the Psychiatric Research Institute at UAMS, author of two books, A Third on the Way, and she knows all about matri-money.
Money is one of those big topics in relationships that absolutely has to be worked out with a couple. So when you get two people in a relationship and they have two different meanings about money, they can get into a lot of conflicts and arguments when they aren't really going to that deeper level.
Richard Davey of Boise, Idaho has an online boot camp dedicated to getting couples on the same financial page. He regards premarital financial counseling as a better wedding gift than, say,
you know, like a $250 crock pot. Or just anything like that. Give them some financial education.
That's a much tougher sell sometimes after the wedding.
So a big thing I see is when you have too much of an imbalance of interest, when you have one person who's very interested in the finances and the other who isn't.
But that's not the case with the Fishers and the Sharps. They have all been through the Financial Peace University, as taught by financial planning guru Dave Ramsey. Best friends, Reggie and Thomas, even helped facilitate webinars at Fellowship Bible Church. They all hold firm to certain principles like...
When you are in debt, you are a slave to something.
It's freeing having that budget.
Having a budget every month, telling our money where to go instead of wondering where the heck it went. Be on the same page and figure out why you want to do something.
Reggie is so averse to debt, he even has artwork made up of cut-up credit cards. Ah, but fate can test a couple's confidence.
Because people's money situation changes over the arc of a lifetime.
Example of what's happening in 26% of American marriages, the wife starts making more money than the husband.
And then his wife makes more than him, he may feel in some way diminished by that.
Or this, according to the Financial Therapy Association, 27% of married couples have kept a financial secret from one another. This is when you want to remember the bottom line.
It's not about the money. It's never about the money. It's about what the money represents, what it touches into, the meaning, the history.
Creating dialogue that can pacify even the strongest willed couples.
Couples need a shared vision for their lives.
Knowing the role, knowing the goal, it makes for a far more productive hive. Okay, here's your takeaway. Breakups can occur for dozens of reasons, but there are enough resources out there that money should never be one of those reasons. In fact, the Couples Center at UAMS is about to begin a relationship seminar starting the day after Valentine's Day. We got your connections where you can get a part of that and all the other resources to this story on THV11.com, Dawn.
I love this. So they both got out of debt.
Both of those families got out of debt through a systematic, disciplined, budgetary savings, and now they're both out of debt. And in the Fisher's case, they had student debt.
That's a substantial amount of debt.
Oh, it was, because she's a doctor. Yeah. You know how much med students, how much they roll up.
Oh, yeah.
And I got to note one other thing. The reason we were in our sock feet with the Fisher's house is because they had new carpet down and they didn't want to spend money on a carpet cleaner.
I noticed your socks.
Exactly. They are saving money.